Hi, I'm Alyssa Ford Morell. I'm an Extension Master Gardener with the Master Gardeners of Northern Virginia, here today in my own yard to talk about invasive plants, specifically one invasive plant, Ornithogalum nutans, or Star of Bethlehem. Before I talk too much about that plant, though, I want to talk about what invasiveness is, because it's not just that a plant spreads too much and we don't like it. It has a very formal definition laid out in two presidential orders that were signed in 1999 and 2016 by Presidents Clinton and Obama. That definition says, first of all, that the plant or animal is not native in the area in which it is occurring. And Star of Bethlehem absolutely fits that because it is native to Eastern Europe and the Middle East. So it's not native here at all. Also, an invasive plant is able to escape cultivation where we have planted it, where we think we want it, and get out into the natural areas. And in those natural areas, it can outcompete the native plants, animals, causing harm. It can cause harm to the economy, to the environment, or harm to plant, animal, or human health. And that is indeed something that has been applied to the Star of Bethlehem because it is outcompeting our native spring ephemerals. Now, that being said, it's a very pretty plant. I will never say that invasive plants aren't pretty. This plant has a lovely six-petaled white habit. It's fairly small and diminutive. It's part of the lily family. What happened here in my yard is that on this slope, when we bought the home, there was lawn that we mowed always. And that went on for years as we laid the plans for the native plant garden that we would eventually put in. And then in the year 2020, we actually got to put that garden in and we killed off the lawn and started planting native plants. Made us very happy. We did that very early in 2020. But guess what came up then? Star of Bethlehem, which we had no idea was here, because Star of Bethlehem has two different ways of spreading. It can spread either by seed, planting more of itself sexually by spreading its seed around, or by bulb offsets. Since we had been mowing for so many years, it had never had a chance to bloom. It looked just like grass. The leaves are actually very small and strappy leaves that look a lot like grass. And so we couldn't tell. Here's one. One of the things that it does have is a kind of a silvery midrib in a little divot along the blade. So the Star of Bethlehem in my yard had been spreading by bulbs reproducing underground, and it had covered much of this area. So since 2020, every spring when they come up and I'm able to identify them, I spend a lot of time digging them up. Now, there are a very few chemicals that can be used on them. They have to be used very carefully. But even the literature that recommends what to use says you'll have to use it several times, several years running, because it's very resistant to chemicals. I did try some of that, and if you want to do that, we always recommend that at the end of your search term, you use the phrase site:EDU so that you are able to access good literature from educational institutions. So it's based on science, not on hearsay. But really, every source that I have found says that the best way to remove Star of Bethlehem is to hand dig it out. You have to get the bulbs out, however, and that can be tricky because they're quite deep. Now you can see I don't have very much Star of Bethlehem here anymore. I've been relatively successful, but I have a ways yet to go because, as you can see, there's a few of these little white flowers sprinkled around here. To show you how to dig them out, we're going to go over to the Glen Carlin Library Garden, where we recently found a stand of Star of Bethlehem, which will be a little bit easier to demonstrate on camera than here. To show you how to dig out the Star of Bethlehem, we're here at Glen Carlin Library Garden, where we found a patch, and it's a pretty big patch. We're not sure how we've missed it in the past, but sometimes invasives can sneak up on you like that. This is the Star of Bethlehem. The flowers have just closed up. They're just gone. So this is, you know, very soon the whole thing will disappear. What you need to do is make sure that you've got the right plant, and I want to show you again. See, here's a leaf, and see how it has this rather silvery midrib. That's one of the indicators besides the flower of what you've got. So what you have to do is really dig down, because you don't know exactly how far down the bulbs will be. And it's better to dig too far than not far enough. If you don't go far enough, the bulb will break off and you may not be able to get at it. So here I'm trying to dig up this whole clump, and we'll see how I did. Here we go. You can see here are all these bulbs, and the bulbs are kind of long. They're not really round, and this is what I have found in my experience, that they are long like this, and they can just grow in these clumps because they divide by bulb. And you can see here's a whole big bunch of them. You can see these ones are attached here. That's spread by offsetting by bulb, not by seed. Once you've gotten your Star of Bethlehem out, and I do warn you, it may be a multi-year task that you can only do while they're up and you can see them. But once you have them up and out of your garden, you can replant with some of our absolutely beautiful native spring ephemerals. The first replacement plant that I'd like to recommend is also here in my garden. It's Virginia bluebells, Mertensia virginica. They have the most beautiful color. About my favorite color in nature is the blue of the bluebells. Unfortunately, we're just past bloom as we film this, but I want to take the opportunity here in my garden, since we're seeing the seed heads just as they're starting to develop, to give you a tip that I didn't have when I started planting them. And that is to plant them, if you have a slope, at the top of your slope, because when they drop their seeds will go downhill and you'll fill up your garden that way. I planted most of mine at the bottom, and so I've got a big bunch of them at the bottom of the garden and not very many at the top. Virginia bluebells generally start off as a more pink or purple color than the beautiful blue that they end up when fully in blossom. There is a rare white variation. Virginia bluebells tolerate rabbits and black walnut and are seldom damaged by deer. They support a number of different native bees and butterflies and moths, and when they're planted in mass, they provide cover for wildlife in spring. The second replacement that I'd like to suggest for invasive Star of Bethlehem is Spring Beauty, Claytonia virginica. We're here at Mount Cuba Center, which specializes in native plants, and they have the best stand of Spring Beauties that I think I've ever seen.
Spring Beauties are ephemeral, meaning that they disappear as the trees leaf out and temperatures rise. The delicate petals of Spring Beauty have pink lines that help guide pollinators to find the nectar. The star-like flowers close up at night or in overcast weather to protect the pollen.
We're still at Mount Cuba Center with the third replacement plant for invasive Star of Bethlehem, and that is the absolutely wonderful great white trillium, Trillium grandiflorum. Trillium has a hallmark of things coming in threes. They have three petals and three bracts that look like
leaves. Trillium spreads very slowly by rhizome and also by seeds carried by ants. Once the seeds germinate, it can take 7 years before the first bloom. Trilliums like partial shade to full shade and need soil that is deep, rich, and well-drained, but also moist. Great white trillium, of course, blooms as a beautiful white flower, but as it ages, it becomes a dark rosy pink.
Whichever plant you choose to replace invasive Star of Bethlehem, I wish you happy gardening.